For many years I used YouTube as consumption only, watching Hooked on Wood, dreaming to make something and contribute one day. Only the plans just were capturing dust, not having a single clue where to begin. Until I just started with one simple click. Yes, that was me. And it's already 1 year ago that I started this YouTube channel. I stopped overthinking everything and just went for it. I followed my ambitions down the rabbit hole that's called YouTube. And that turned out to be one of the best decisions I made in years. Back then, I could never expect that you guys from all over the world liked and built my design. So I'm very thankful for that, and also for all the amazing support on my Patreon site. Now I'm really sure that we can build great things together. So let's step up our game. For you who are new here, hello, welcome, I'm Ruud and I like to design and make stuff. Last year I managed to make 10 videos about the process of solving my biggest dust problem in my shop. I made a centrifugal dust separator and placed it above my planer. It's a game changer for my shop. Only what's up next for this channel? What am I working on? And what can you expect from me in the future? I want to learn everything about dust separation, with a focus on centrifugal dust separator designs, and try out new things. I'm going to build bigger and smaller versions of the centrifugal dust separator to find out if there is any performance differences. And I'm looking for small changes that has massive effect on the performance. For the setup above my planer, I'm going to integrate motors and a filter into the design. And I'm also going to test some more classical designs. Yes, I know that are high ambitions to achieve in 1 year, beside a full-time job. But the only way to eat an elephant is piece by piece. So don't expect a new video every week from me. More in the trend of 5 to 10 each year. Quality matters. And I will post small updates on my Patreon. In order to achieve the goals more quickly, I need to take a step back and find out a way to make a better test setup. Because using a hammer to open the cam vac after each test and cleaning it out is not effective anymore going forward. My idea is to make a filter device between the separator and the cam vac that can be removed easy and put on a scale. I used the full bed size of my printer to make the adapter with the grid to attach the different filters against. Only the edge got warped, and the compression tape need to fix that. This is only a quick assembly to measure the resistance without any filter material in it. And I used hardware that I had laying around in my studio. I made myself a YouTube pressure gauge to measure its pressure loss. It's a simple device with water in a tube, with one side connected in front and the other after the filter. When water rises in the tube, it's a sign of increased friction in the system. So we want to design a filter with the least amount of water difference. And now we have the baseline test done, we can try out different filter materials. And I had seen someone made a filter out of a paper towel. But I expect a lot of resistance, so let's try that out first. Activating one motor alone already produced 12 cm of water resistance. And the water went out of scale when the second motor was activated. Switching to a thinner towel was even worse. And the paper tore when the third motor was activated. My hopes on success went out to the vacuum cleaner bag. It needed to be cut apart because I only needed the backside of it, without the hole. Its size matched that with the paper towels, so I could use it on the same adapter. Activating the first motor was very promising. And turning on the second motor stayed within the scale. Also the resistance with all three motors enabled stayed within the range and came out on 28 cm of water resistance. The pressure resistance is only one piece of the puzzle, and I'm more interested in the air speed, so we can calculate the volume of air that is passing through the system in cubic feet per minute. And for that I use my BT meter and my 3D printed jig to keep the BT meter always centered in the right spot. I started with the baseline test, with on the left the airspeed without anything attached to the cam vac, and at the right with the adapter without filters. Readings of the airspeed were almost the same due to the high pressure and high flow capabilities of the cam vac. And with the different filters attached, the cam vac struggled much more to keep the air moving, compared to the baseline. The thin paper towels loses up to 40% on airspeed. So the paper towels were not even a close match for the vacuum filter bag, because they are made for that exact purpose, of course. But I think we can do better by increasing its total area, filter area, even more. And for that, cartridge filters are made. They have a very large filter area in the compact size. So compared to the vacuum bag, it's much more area. And when we stack more of them together, I think we can reduce the friction even more. I used the small cartridge filters for a shop vac, because the large cartridges won't fit well in an 8-inch tube. That is a leftover for the centrifugal dust separator I'm building in an 8-inch version, to compare it with a 6-inch one. To close the top of the cartridge and guide the air through the filter material, I designed a top cover that is flexible and can be put inside of the tube, with a cone to guide the air. The tube will be cut to length when I have a better understanding on how many filters we will need to reduce the friction enough. Oh, and I printed this cover in 3 parts to eliminate the use of support material. I Frankensteined the first test setup with some clamps to squeeze the filters together. And it turned out that the 3 filters had only a water resistance of around 8 mm. I intend to use 2 filters, so let's remove one and test it again. With all the 3 motors enabled, the resistance more than doubled, up to 21 mm. This resistance of that extra filter was not really noticeable in the measurements of the airspeed. The cam vac is really not impressed and is capable to keep the airspeed the same within the accuracy of this cheap BT meter. It still turned out to be 10 to 20% better than the dust bag though. The unit fitted on the scale. And I added some extra filters to it to be sure that accumulated dust will not increase the resistance too quickly. And you see me use an improvised support because I was really excited to test it in combination with a new version of my third stage separator. I processed 1.4 kg of superfine dust with sizes smaller than 0.5 mm, with a pretty high feed rate, in the range of about 45 kg an hour. And after weighing, it turned out it collected 2.3 grams of sawdust. So that's an accuracy above 99.7%. And for upgrading the brackets, that only took me 3 attempts. And still not happy about that. So instead, I built a small separator. My goal with a small separator is to scale the third stage separator down to a tube of 70 mm, so it can fit inside the dual stage separator before the last Y-piece. And to make that work, I need another video. So this was it for this video. I hope you enjoyed, and I see you in the next one. Keep making. Houdoe!